بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Lipid metabolism. In this top lecture, we're going to sum up this topic, lipid metabolism. It begins from mobilization and transport of fatty acids, triacylglyceraldehyde and sterols. As we know that the processing of dietary fats after taking the dietary lipids, it should be emulsified by bile salts like glycocholic acid or taurocholic acid, intestinal lipases starts bile salts, they further converted macroscopic molecules into finely dispersed molecules to make a micellus. That micellus make accessible with the intestinal lipases, start degraded tags. So that hydrolytic products of tags, they starts diffused from intestinal mucosa, where they again reaggregate to make a triacylglyceraldehyde, and further further pack with a free cholesterol esters, apoproteins to originate the chylomicron. So that chylomicron starts moving towards the target cells, so where they further hydrolyze by lipoprotein lipases, and the remnants they taken up by the chylomicron, they taken up by the target cells, where they transported by a special fatty acid transporters, they internalize and they hydrolyze to give energy in the form of ATP. Hormonal triggers mobilization of stored triacylglyceraldehyde, as we already know, in case of low glucose level, in case of low energy state, hormones they bind on the receptor place on the place on adipocytes, activates G stimulatory proteins that initiate the adenylate cyclase to increase the level of cyclic AMP with phosphorylate protein kinase A. Protein kinase A phosphorylate on one side the perilipin layer, on other side the hormone sensitive lipases, changes its conformation, made accessible with the lipid droplets, allowed to brought out the triacylglyceraldehyde from storage, comes in bloodstream, so where they attach with albumin and they transport it to target cells. Then we're going to discuss the metabolism of plasma lipoproteins. Plasma total lipoproteins exist in plasma that is about 400 to 600 milligrams per deciliter. Plasma lipoproteins, they are spherical complexes, macromolecular, formed by the combination of lipids and proteins. They are found in plasma, involved in transport of insoluble lipids, fat soluble vitamins, sterols and cholesterol, etc. Their composition, all of the lipoproteins, they are generally composed of triacylglyceraldehyde, free cholesterol esters, proteins, monolayers at a different concentrations. Spherical bodies, the core region contains a non-polar component of tags and cholesterol ester that wrap with a polar components. Classify of lipoproteins. We classify lipoproteins on the basis of their densities, on the basis of their tags contents, on the basis of their cholesterol and proteins constants. We classify into chylomicron, VLDL, LDL and HDL. Their composition, apolipoproteins basically is the protein part of the lipoproteins. They serves to maintain the integrity. They activates the enzymes like LCAT and LPL, as well as they deliver the lipids to cell recognition cell surface receptors. This slide shows that the different types of apolipoproteins, their association as well as their functions, which should be useful during metabolisms. So metabolism of lipoproteins, in which we summarize the metabolism of chylomicron. We know that the chylomicron, they originates from mucosal cells after taking the dietary after taking a meal rich of lipids. So these after origination, it brought out in it first come in lymphatic system, then convey to a subclavian vein, so where it enters in the bloodstream. In bloodstream, gives ApoC and ApoE to it takes ApoE and ApoC from HDL, and it gives ApoA1 and ApoA2 from HDL, and after taking it becomes mature and it transferred towards the capillaries of the target tissues, where they activated by LPL. After activating by LPL, they release some, they liberate some tax contents, and they move towards their target cells for further metabolism. VLDL origin, very low density lipoproteins, they originate from liver after taking after the excessive synthesis of TAX, after ethanol intake, after chronic level of cholesterol, after chronic level of carbohydrates. So their level, they're going to be elevated. A major apoprotein is found in VLDL, that is ApoB1, B or ApoB100. So this after originates from liver, it comes in bloodstream, so where it, like chylomicron, it donates ApoC and ApoE series to from HDL to VLDL, and it accept and it donates ApoA1 and ApoA2. So after donation, it becomes mature VLDL. So that mature VLDL, now it starts moving towards the target cells. So on their way, they release some TAX fraction converted into IDL. It release some more fraction to convert it IDL into LDL, low density lipoproteins, and the remaining VLDL remnants, they taken up by the hepatocytes by receptors mediated endocytotic mechanism, where they further metabolized. Low density lipoproteins, its role is, it's involved to transport a cholesterol from the liver to the peripheral tissues. It's a bad cholesterol associated with atherosclerosis, associated to increase the cardiovascular diseases as well as hypercholesterolemia. LDL receptors place on a specific region towards the tissues at a specific region called a clathrin coated pits. So the LDL particles, they attach by the ApoB100 with the specific regions on a clathrin coated pit to make a LDL receptor complex and internalize to fuse with the lysosomes, internalize to fuse with vesicles to form endosomes, and that endosomes further fuse with the lysosomes, and they further degraded by the lysosomal enzyme, is highly regulated process. High density lipoproteins, this one, their components originates from small intestine, and their components brought out from small intestine, and they originates in plasma, where they newly synthesized HDL called a discoidal in shape. They have LCAT enzymes. They have ApoC and ApoE, so which further donated to chylomicron and VLDL particles and accept them A1 and A2 which involved to activate LCAT. LCAT, this enzyme LCAT, which plays on the surface of the newly synthesized HDL, they able to convert it. They able to convert it, the inact, the free cholesterol into cholesterol esters to make a newly synthesized HDL full of cholesterol esters, now called a HDL3 particles. That some of the HDL3 particles taken up by the hepatic sites, where they further degraded by hepatic lipases into their relevant components. That cholesterol they used to make a bile acid. We also discussed that some of the HDL particles which still existing in circulation, that should be replaced their cholesterol esters with tax particles. Cholesterol esters starts moving from HDL to chylomicron VLDL IDL, and they receive tax from them. After receiving tax, so now the new HDL particles which are full of tax, we called HDL2s. So that HDL2 taken up by the hepatocytes by receptors mediated endocytotic mechanisms, where they further metabolized. Now this slide shows the names, defects, and the remarks, diseases called associated with the lipoproteinemias, hypolipoproteinemias, as well as hyperlipoproteinemias. We already discussed the with their defects, as well as with some remarks or interpretation. Triacylglyceraldehyde metabolism, as we already know, that the triacylglyceraldehyde, they synthesize in liver, stored in adipocytes, and they brought out from adipocytes in case of hypoglycemia, in case of fasting or starvation. Synthesis of triacylglyceraldehyde promoted by insulin. Synthesis occurs, which is the precursor for synthesis of triacylglyceraldehyde, is glycerophosphate. Glycerophosphate synthesized both in liver and adipocytes by from glycolysis. Glycolysis convert glucose into dihydroxyestrogen phosphate. So this dihydroxyestrogen phosphate directly converted into glyceraldehyde phosphate by the enzyme glycerophosphate dehydrogenase utilizing NADH. In liver, another enzyme glycerophosphate directly converted glycerol into glycerophosphate by utilizing ATP. Now this glycerol 3-phosphate taken up the fatty acyl CoA, release CoA, make a lysophosphatidic acid. This lysophosphatidic acid converted into phosphatidic acid diacylglycerol, and after incorporation of third fatty acid converted into fatty into triacylglycerol. Now degradation. Degradation take place in starvation or in case of fasting. So more degradation of TAX occurs. Release of fatty acid from TAX initiated by hormone sensitive lipases placed in fat droplets. Epinephrine, they attach on receptors. Epinephrine or glucagon, they attach on the receptors placed on adipocytes, activate adenylate cyclase, increase cyclic AMP, increase active protein kinase A. This phosphorylate hormone sensitive lipases starts phospholipases make accessible to this hormone sensitive lipase to lipid droplets, starts hydrolyzing triacylglyceraldehyde, liberated fatty acid, and converted into their hydrolytic products. That from hydrolytic products, the fatty acid they brought out in bloodstream move to their target tissues by the help of albumin, so where they further internalize in target cells, where they further oxidize by from the beta oxidation and liberate energy. Fatty acid synthesis, biosynthesis occur in cytosol. Here are the steps for fatty acid synthesis. Production of cytosolic acetyl-CoA citrate brought out have a permeability to cross from the mitochondrial membrane. Citrate after brought it further separate to give acetyl-CoA and oxaloacetate. Now this acetyl-CoA is the cytosolic acetyl-CoA is ready to synthesize fatty acids. Then carboxylation of acetyl-CoA to malonyl-CoA. Then the rest of after formation of malonyl-CoA, activation of this as the mechanism, it shows that how the activation occurs by the enzyme acetyl-CoA carboxylase, which converts acetyl-CoA into malonyl-CoA. Then once the malonyl-CoA is formed, the rest of the reaction taking place in the multi-complex enzyme fatty acid synthase, which comprises of six enzyme and one ACP molecule. So they have two active sites, one at condensing enzyme keto acyl synthase, another with ACP molecule. One is the acceptor of acetyl-CoA, another is the acceptor of malonyl-CoA, which further condense to make acetoacetate. Three reaction occurs, first reduction, then hydration, then second reduction to make a 4-carbon containing butyryl acetyl-CoA, which shift from monomer 2 to monomer 1 and keep the monomer 2 free to accommodate a new malonyl-CoA. So this sequence of repetition repeated again and again until and unless the two molecules of palmitic acid they synthesize in each monomers at a time. At last determination occurs, release ACP molecule to make the palmitic acid free. Yes, after synthesized, the fatty acid should be activated. Activated fatty acid synthesized in cytosol in this form, that is inactivated, it should be before it for enters in TC cycle, it should be activated. Activated after taking the coenzyme A group to make a fatty acyl CoA by the enzyme a fatty acyl CoA synthetase. This enzyme utilizes two ATP molecule. To ATP hydrolyzed into AMP and pyrophosphate. Enzyme located at the outer and inner mitochondrial membrane which convert inactive fatty acid into activated fatty acids. Oxidation takes place in mitochondrial matrix by the help of the carnitine shuttle complex. By the help of this carnitine shuttle complex, cytosolic fatty acyl CoA release coenzyme A attached with carnitine, fatty acyl carnitine now translocated inside the mitochondrial matrix by the enzyme carnitine acyl transferase 1. Release carnitine return back to accommodate a new fatty acids. Now this is fatty acyl CoA attached with coenzyme A to make a mitochondrial fatty acyl CoA. Now this mitochondrial fatty acyl CoA is ready to oxidize further. The whole of the reaction is catalyzed by carnitine acyl transferase 2. Here this slide shows the oxidation, the steps of the oxidation of fatty acids. Stages of fatty acid oxidation: in first stage beta oxidation occurs, in second stage so acetyl CoA they internalize in TC cycle, liberate carbon dioxide and generate the reducing equivalents in the form of NADH plus H and FADH2. So these NADH reducing equivalents donates electrons in mitochondrial respiratory chain, by which the electron passes to molecule oxygen, phosphorylation occurs to generate energy in the form of ATP. Beta oxidation located in mitochondrial matrix steps included dehydrogenation, hydration, then second dehydrogenation, then thiolytic cleavage. 16 carbon saturated palmitic acid that undergoes dehydrogenation, hydration, second dehydrogenation, and thyroid cleavage. In first deiodogenation, it yield FADH2, then water is added, then it generate NADH plus H, then then thiolytic cleavage to release acetyl, the end product of beta oxidation to yield acetyl CoA and fatty acyl CoA. So after a repetition of 6 more cycles, so the complete 1 molecule of palmitic acid gives 8 molecule of acetyl CoA, 7 NADH plus H and 7 FADH2, so which equivalent to 131 ATP molecules, 2 already utilized during activation, so the net ATP yield is 129. Medium chain fatty acyl CoA dehydrogenase deficiency, approximately it's 1 in 10,000 births, leads to decreased fatty acid oxidation, becomes impaired, causes a severe hypoglycemia, vomiting occurs at different intervals, sleepiness. 10% cases sudden and faint death syndromes. In this case, a frequent intake of carbohydrate should be given to patient. Otherwise, if that patient is not taking the carbohydrates orally, it should be given the primary treatment of MCAD deficiency to give the glucose via from intravenously. Other modes of oxidation of fatty acids included oxidation of unsaturated fatty acids, oxygen fatty acids, alpha oxidation, omega oxidation, and peroxisomal oxidation. Unsaturated fatty acids required 2 additional reactions in which isomerases and reductases take place. Isomerases convert the cis conformation into trans conformation if the fatty acid is a mono unsaturated fatty acid, and reductases is the auxiliary enzymes used to convert the cis conformation into trans conformation if the fatty acid is a polyunsaturated fatty acid, and the remaining reaction is same like a beta oxidation. Then oxidation of odd number fatty acid propionyl-CoA. Odd number fatty acid propionyl-CoA undergoes carboxylation, and by the help of mutase, it changes the intramolecular arrangement of molecule to convert the propionyl-CoA into methylmalonyl-CoA, and methylmalonyl-CoA by the help of mutase. This enzyme utilizes vitamin B12 to convert it into succinyl-CoA. Steps of alpha oxidation includes hydroxylation, dehydrogenation, decarboxylation, then produce a odd chain fatty acid to convert the phytanic acid, 20 carbon branch in phytanic acid, into pristanic acid. So that pristanic acid, by the help of alpha hydroxyphytonate enzyme, to convert it into pristanic acid. If this enzyme is deficient, phytonate alpha oxidase or phytonate alpha hydroxylase, this enzyme is deficient, that leads to a Rebsum disease, which causes the retinitis pigmentosa. Omega oxidation occurs in endoplasmic reticulum of liver and kidneys, also in brain microsomes. Substrate used 10 to 12 fatty acids in which the hydroxylation occurs, production of dicarboxylic acids that undergoes a beta oxidation to yield acetyl CoA and succinyl CoA, with further oxidized in TCA cycle. Peroxisomal fatty acid oxidation. Peroxisomal fatty acid oxidation occurs in peroxisomes completed in mitochondria, very long chain fatty acid. The purpose of peroxisomal fatty acid oxidation, a very long chain fatty acid undergoes oxidation. The end product is octanyl CoA and acetyl CoA. Inherited disorders, Zellweger syndrome, we're going to be discussed. We already discussed in Zellweger syndrome. So in Zellweger syndrome, a rare inborn error, peroxisomal fatty acid oxidation is due to inherited absence of functional peroxisomes in different tissues, in carnitine deficiency, incarnitine deficiency, hypoglycemia, impairment of fatty acid oxidation occurs, impaired ketogenesis occurs, accumulation of lipids causes carnitine palmitoyl transferase deficiency, Jamaicans vomiting sickness, and Jamaicans vomiting sickness, disease caused by eating an unripe fruit of an egg tree which contains a toxin hypoglycin. That causes a short chain acyl that inactivates a medium and short chain acyl CoA dehydrogenase causes hypoglycemia. Regulation of fatty acid oxidation depends upon the rate of transfer of long chain fatty acyl CoA into mitochondria. An increased concentration of NADH plus H oblique NAD inhibits dehydrogenase, as well as increased concentration of acetyl CoA inhibits thiolase and stop the further beta oxidation. Coordinated regulation of fatty acid synthesis and breakdown in response of high blood glucose, in response of low blood glucose, in response of high blood glucose, promote insulin, converts acetyl CoA more into malonyl CoA, stops CAT1 in mitochondria. In case of low blood glucose, we know that ACCS, acetyl CoA carboxylase, become phosphorylated and inactive. After inactivated, it activates carnitine acyl transferase 1 in mitochondria and inhibits the synthesis of fatty acids. Ketone bodies metabolism. Ketone bodies an alternative fuel for cells. Ketone bodies synthesis occur in liver by condensing the two molecule of acetyl CoA into acetoacetyl CoA. This going to be formed of HMG CoA. So the first two steps are similar to the cholesterol synthesis. Acetoacetate is formed with further reduced into beta hydroxybutyrate by utilizing NADH plus H and acetoacetate. Both of them, they comes in bloodstream, move towards the target tissues where they further hydrolyze to give 3-hydroxybutyrate hydrolyze to generate NADH plus H gives acetoacetate. Acetoacetate taken up coenzyme A from succinyl CoA by thiophorase. This enzyme is missing in liver. So that is why the liver produce ketone bodies but not utilized due to a deficiency of this enzyme. Physiological significance of ketogenesis, their regulations included the lipolysis take place, more production of free fatty acid brought in bloodstream, then comes in livers, in liver either converted into a fatty acyl CoA esterified to give tags, or either they oxidize by from the beta oxidation give acetyl CoA, and further it channeled the ketogenesis, the formation of ketone bodies. Ketosis, causes of ketosis are sweat, diabetes mellitus, as well as in starvation. Consequences of ketosis, we know that ketone bodies when it starts appearing in blood to cause ketonemia. Whenever it increases the renal threshold level, it appears in urine to causes the ketonuria, and the resultant volatile substances volatile non-metabolized substance called acetone, which comes in breathing of in diabetic patient, which causes dizziness, gives a specific fruity smell. So these are the consequences of ketosis. Ketone body is going to be diagnosed by Rothfuss test. Ketoacidosis, the condition in which the two strong acid, acetoacetate and beta hydroxybutyrate, both of the strong acid, they keep releasing protons in a decreased level of plasma, and this more protons circulating in decreased level of plasma in hypovolemic condition. leads to a acidosis called ketoacidosis. Fatty liver and lipotropic factors. Fatty livers, they refers with the deposition of excess tags in the liver and causes are the excessive mobilization of fatty acid, excess calories intake, injury, toxic injury to liver, alcoholism. Fatty liver may progresses to cirrhosis. Lipotropic factors are those which prevents from fatty livers, like lecithin, choline, and methionine. Synthesis of eicosanoids. Eicosanoids, metabolism of eicosanoids. We know that the phospholipids, phosphatidylene acetyl, the carbon number 2 of the phosphatidylene acetyl contains arachidonic acid. Arachidonic acid released from a membrane bounded by phospholipase A2. Phospholipase A2 allowed to release arachidonic acid. Release of arachidonic acid further activates PTH synthase to give a PTH2. So this PTH2 defer drive prostaglandins and thromboxanes by from the cyclic oxygenase pathway, as well as by using the lipoxygenase pathway to give the leukotrienes. These inhibited by NSAIDs, non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, COX-1 and COX-2. Their physiological function, that triggers the inflammation, down-regulates the blood pressures, promotes coagulation and thrombosis like thromboxanes, inhibits coagulation and thrombosis like prostacycline, and contraction of bronchial smooth muscles, as well as to stimulate the slow reacting substances of anaphylactic shocks. Cholesterol metabolisms. Cholesterol biosynthesis occur in liver as well as other steroidogenic tissues. Cholesterol should be obtained, taken up from the dietary sources, even a cholesterol synthesized in extrahepatic tissues. Dietary cholesterol consumption, absorption, total excretion 1000 milligrams, 800 to 1000 milligrams synthesized cholesterol per day by from de novo synthesis. Cholesterol synthesis occur in cytosol, required NADH plus H into ATP reaction, highly regulated process. Acetyl-CoA, the first two steps similar to ketogenesis to make a mevalonic acid. Mevalonic acid undergoes catalyzed by kinases to make a 5-pyrophosphomevalonic acid. This 5-pyrophosphomevalonic acid undergoes to give isopentanyl pyrophosphate. Isopentanyl pyrophosphate isomerizes or epimerizes into 3,3-dimethylallyl pyrophosphate. In this, another molecule of isopentanyl pyrophosphate to give a 10-carbon geranyl pyrophosphate. In 10-carbon geranyl pyrophosphate, another isopentanyl pyrophosphate accumulated to make a 15-carbon furanosyl pyrophosphate to give a 30-carbon unstable sequilene that converted into lanosterol, and after 4 steps, lanosterol converted into cholesterol. We already learned. Regulation of cholesterol feedback inhibition. The regulatory enzyme for cholesterol biosynthesis is HMG-CoA reductase. This enzyme in it also regulated hormonally. Insulin promotes cholesterol biosynthesis, and on the other hand, glucagon and epinephrine, they inhibits the activity of HMG-CoA reductase and stop the further cholesterol biosynthesis. Cholesterol biosynthesis also transcriptionally controlled by the specific protein sterol regulatory element binding proteins. If sterol level is low, like in case of low cholesterol, so this sterol regulatory element binding protein able to keep hydrolyzing the active amino group by the help of two proteases, CAP and SP2 proteins, leave active amino group. That active amino group from steroregulatory element binding protein starts moving inside the nucleus, where they further attach with the steroregulatory element, starts transcription and increase the production of HMG-CoA reductases. Clinical aspects: serum cholesterol is correlated with incidence of coronary heart diseases and atherosclerosis. Statin drugs decrease the HMG-CoA reductase activity, included lovastatin, atorvastatin, mevastatin. Synthesis of bile acids and bile salts occur in liver, then they transported and stored in the bile. Synthesis of bile acid that should be regulated in the presence of ascorbic acid as well as more bile acid stop this regulatory enzyme 7-alpha-hydroxylase. 7-alpha-hydroxylase further undergo utilizing molecule oxygen NAD pH plus H release propionyl-CoA to make a cholic acid or quinodeoxycholic acid. That cholic acid and quinodeoxycholic acid are primary bile acids. They further, before it leaves from liver, it should be conjugated with the taurine and glycine to make a primary bile salts. That brought out in bile move towards the ileum, so where they further absorbed. Bile salts, they stored in gallbladder and they release in intestine while we taking up a diet which is rich in cholesterol, rich in lipids diet. This movement of bile acids from bile to ileum, from ileum to portal vein, and from portal vein it returns back into hepatocytes. This circulation of bile acids is called the enterohepatic circulation. In case of enterohepatic circulation, bile acid which produced by liver that should be utilized multiple times. Cholelithiasis. If normally the bile acid they normally brought out in bile along with the phospholipids and cholesterol, if this excessive amount of cholesterol should be brought out in bile, and if this process is disrupted due to a less production of bile acid, and less production of bile acids brought out in bile, so resultant cholesterol, excessive cholesterol starts precipitating, stored in gallbladder, and it gives a gallstone, converted into gallstone, so we called a cholelithiasis. Cholelithiasis, they further to performing the laparoscopic cholecystectomy, so the removal of gallstone, or it should be if a patient not if a patient not tolerate the surgery, so that should be given the chemo therapy consists of a quinodeoxycholic acid up to 6 months to 1 year just to complete dilation of gallstones. Atherosclerosis, here we're going to discuss the events related to atherosclerosis. Here are the we already discussed the vascular risk factors in cardiac heart diseases, included arterial hypertension, elevated circulating level of various lipids, cigarette smoking, diabetes mellitus, chronic elevation in blood glucose level, high circulating level of vasoconstricting octapeptide, and others. Biochemical aspects of atherosclerosis: formation of fatty streaks, macrophages, foam cells, aggregation of platelets, thrombus formation, then form of fibrous caps, they thinning towards their peripheral region, fibrous cap become ruptured, leads to acute thrombosis formation, infarction occurs, consequences of macromolecular ischemic events as well as acute cerebrovascular accidents. So that's all about summarized form of lipids metabolism.